Just over 6 months until Britain leaves the EU, negotiations have reached a critical point. Will a deal be reached, or will the UK leave without a deal? British Prime Minister Theresa May has spent the last 24 hours with the other 27 EU leaders who hold her country's future in their hands. Europe correspondent Joy Reid is across developments and is with us this morning. Tēnā koe, Joy. Thanks for being here. Can you just bring us up to speed with things?
Well, there's only really about 8 more weeks for the UK and the EU to come up with some kind of deal on what's going to look like when the pair separate in March. And by all means, it's extraordinarily complicated. It's never been done before. Some are saying it's the most difficult thing any officials have had or any government's had to do since World War II. They're pretty much making it up as they go along. So Theresa May has come up with a plan called the Chequers Deal, and she took this to Austria to the meeting of the 27 and other EU leaders, and she was hoping for some kind of positive response for it. But in the past 24 hours, that plan certainly did fall flat on its face. Donald Tusk coming out today saying her proposed economic partnership simply will not work. A lot of criticism too about their plans on what to do about the Irish border. And we saw just a couple of hours ago Theresa May come out in a press conference looking quite unusually flustered, certainly pretty frustrated about things because it hasn't really gone to plan. The past 24 hours, she hasn't garnered more support. In fact, it's just got more people asking more questions.
So the UK isn't set to leave until March, but what happens if they can't reach a deal in, say, the next 8 weeks?
Yeah, well, that's a really good question. And effectively, at the moment, the EU is coming up and it seems to be holding most of the cards and saying, look, budge, compromise, come over to our side, or there won't be an option. But the Theresa May is now holding up a pretty big card in her hand, saying, well, look, we are negotiating, we are compromising, and if we don't come to the party, then we're going to leave anyway, and we're going to leave without a deal. And the reason that this is significant is this would be far more expensive, far more chaotic than if it did leave with a deal, when we're talking huge queues at borders, at ports, potentially shortage of foods and medicines temporarily, as things got sorted. Trade would have to resort back to World Trade Organization tariffs. So certainly not at all what anyone would be wanting. But Theresa May has said, look, no deal is better than a bad deal, and she's not afraid to use it.
Joy, are there some particular sticking points between the negotiators?
Well, yes, the Irish border issue is pretty much the main issue. So where Northern Ireland meets the Republic of Ireland, this is the only physical land border that there would be between the EU and the UK. And nobody wants to see a hard border. They don't want to see border posts going back up there. And so they're just trying to figure out what to do. The EU wants a backstop solution, which would essentially leave Northern Ireland in under the EU customs, trade rules, etc. But the UK saying, heck no, you're not going to be splitting up our country. We're not having one rule for part of the UK and one rule for the rest of them. And there seems to be a very, very large stalemate there. The other issue really is around trade, the future economic partnership, how things will look in terms of tariff. And again, they seem to be very, very far apart on what they think on this. And both sides really are now just playing chicken with each other to see who's going to budge first.
Any chance we'll see a second referendum?
Well, calls for that are certainly growing. The People's Vote campaign are asking definitely that whatever is negotiated as a deal, or if there is no deal, it should go back to the public, that the public get to choose whether they want to go through with that or whether they just want to stay under the current agreements. Theresa May has always said very, very firmly, absolutely no way, this will not happen. The people have already voted back in the 2016 referendum. We're not having a second one. But after disastrous 24 hours like the ones we've just seen right now in Austria, it certainly does seem that this argument will be gaining traction.
All right, thanks so much for your time this morning, Joy.